Looks like Terrence Crawford and Amir Khan will face each other April 20th. Stay tuned. Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button, also subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. If you want to become part of the gang, notification gang, please hit the bell icon. Shout out to the Super Chats channel donations, the Venmo donations, and the Patreon family. We working now. I told you guys it looked like this was going to happen. Now, sources are telling me that Amir Khan is decided on fighting Terrence Crawford. Initially, it was going to be taking place in March, maybe with Errol Spence and Mikey Garcia being March 16th. Maybe they thought a week after that wouldn't be the best optimal time for a fight, or maybe negotiations took longer. But sources are saying that Amir Khan will challenge Terrence Crawford in New York April 20th. And I want to give some just brief thoughts on the situation. I think it's a difficult fight for Amir Khan. See, this is the thing about Amir Khan. He's a very good fighter. Khan has a good resume. He's been in there with the likes of Canelo, Marco Antonio Barrera. You know, even though it was probably not the best version, or the youthful Marco Antonio babyface. But he's a silver medalist. He's been in there with Luis Collazo and a slew of other names. So he's a dangerous fight for anyone when it comes to experience. He has killer speed. The biggest gripe that people have that I've seen with Amir Khan is when the going gets tough and he's hit and, you know, connected with the big shots, will his chin hold up? You know, we have not seen him since the Canelo fight anyone elite since that point. You know, so this is a dangerous fight. Terrence Crawford has a lot of momentum, but this could be a high-speed chess match in terms of you're dealing with two boxers. And I look at Terrence Crawford as one of the guys leading the pack. This is a title shot for Amir Khan. You know, some people say he hasn't really deserved it, because since the Canelo fight, he fought Phil LaGreco and he fought against Samuel Vargas, and he really struggled with Samuel Vargas, got knocked down, he didn't look great. But anytime you have a big name, you deserve it. The fights get made, right? That's just the reality of boxing. Or guys who have veteran resumes like Gabe Rosado's, and, you know, even if they have losses, you see them in title fights. So we know the rules of boxing. It's an interesting matchup. I really wish it happened a couple of years ago, but I'm still gonna watch it. I still support it. Obviously, the best fights for Terrence Crawford are on the PBC side across the fence, but it looks like we're gonna have to wait. Errol Spence has business with Mikey Garcia. Danny Garcia is already lined up for Adrian Granado. Sean Porter already has a fight with you guys. So no matter what, if you really think about it, this is probably the best available guy that Amir Khan could have fought outside of Kell Brook that is available. Now, speaking of the Kell Brook, it's a shame that Eddie Hearns, he came over to America with this DAZN proposition and stuff, and he has not been able to facilitate the types of fights. Like, how do you have Kell Brook? So basically, you know, me and Mitch Lebrani, you know, you got Kell Brook, you got Amir Khan, and you have them both signed, which people didn't even see Khan going over to Eddie Hearns based on the history, and you have them both signed, but yet you can't make the Kell Brook versus Amir Khan fight. Now, to add insult to injury, if I'm not the smartest brother in the world and the fight hasn't been fully announced, but this is technically a rumor, but it looks like it's happening April 20th. This doesn't sound like a DAZN card, because the A side of this equation is Terrence Crawford, who fights on ESPN. So that really means that Khan, who's pretty much kind of like a Mikey Garcia, and he goes flex and feels wherever he, you know, wherever he, it makes the most sense. He fought Canelo on HBO. He fought on PBC cards. He's been fighting on DAZN cards last two fights. So that's the status of his career. He kind of has that. He's been in the game a while. He has that type of leverage. So I don't believe that DAZN will be the one streaming this fight. I don't see. I think it'll be an ESPN fight. So, you know, it's a solid fight, but I don't think DAZN's gonna get it, you know, because I think ESPN, unless they're doing some kind of joint thing. But I'll wait for that part before I speculate. But aside from all of that, it's like, how does Eddie Hearns have Kell Brook and Amir Khan and can't get it done? And some people are thinking like, oh, if he's willing to fight Canelo and Terrence Crawford, then there's no way he would avoid a Kell Brook. But I disagree. I disagree with, it does look like Amir Khan doesn't want to fight Kell Brook. You know, he says, I don't want to give him the payday. I think it really stems from the bragging rights. They're both from the same region. Losing to Canelo, he's from Mexico. He has nothing to do with being from Bolton or UK or UK bragging rights. Same thing with Terrence Crawford. He's from Omaha. So it's just like nobody wants to lose that fight to like your arch nemesis, someone you've been bickering with for the last 6 to 8 years. You know, traded sparring stories. The world that night would see what it was and what it wasn't, you know. So I think Amir Khan views the Kell Brook fight as more dangerous, not in the sense that he can't lose to a guy like Crawford or to Canelo, but he would lose bragging rights, UK bragging rights, if he were to lose to Kell Brook. And it seems like that's the holdup. And I feel sorry for Kell Brook because he was pretty much the Anthony Joshua for Eddie Hearns before Anthony Joshua. He's been calling for this fight with Amir Khan, can't get it. Now you got guys like Swift Jared Hurd, who's a big ass dude at 54, and he's trying to fight Kell Brook, you know, and he's not the only, there's other people calling, you know, Jermell Charlo said he'll fight Kell Brook. So Kell Brook's in between a rock and a hard spot. He didn't really look good versus the stripper, Michael Zarafa, and he kind of got starved out of the picture. Terrence Crawford is going to show us what he's talking about with Amir Khan, vice versa. And Kell Brook, I don't even know who he's going to fight, because like I said, he didn't look great. And his big money fight was the Khan fight. And it looks like Khan went another route, another direction. And, you know, maybe he's going to have to take a tough fight with a true 54 pounder. And them guys is looking like killers. Let me know what you guys think. Terrence Crawford, Amir Khan, very interesting match. You know, I don't know exactly how to feel about it. I just know Crawford will likely be the favorite. He's proven to have more momentum and just in the past be more durable. But we'll see if Khan, with his speed, his veteran experience, and his boxing ability, and he has a good size. I have to see them next to each other, but Khan might be a little bit like taller, longer, pause. So we'll see how it matches up. Very interesting stylistic matchup. Let me know who wins, but that is the latest. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. Make sure you smash the like button as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. 10x Videos Ego. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.